Internet is awesome, but people are creepy, especially those whose job is to spy on all of us and make it look like Russians did it. Everything we love is tracking us. The new business model is to design a product that offers little convenience at low or zero price, in exchange for unlimited generation of data that are collected and sold to the highest bidder. You're not a customer anymore, you've become the product. If you don't want to rationalize this through "I have nothing to hide" nonsense,
you have nothing to fear if you have nothing to hide.
It can be really uncomfortable to do anything on the web. You may feel like you could only hide in a cage and stay there forever. I think I have a pretty good strategy that you can learn in under 10 minutes. It is an easy, convenient, and fast way to protect your privacy, and I'm going to show you just that in this video. So let's get to it.
Shall we?
Here is what I see a lot of people are doing wrong. They open their browser, first app is their Facebook, second is Gmail. They leave them open all day while they browse for work, school or fun. And because Facebook and Google plant cookies on your device that send to them your uniquely identifying information along with everything you do on that browser, they now own and sell everything they collect. The solution to this is to compartmentalize. The best way to do this is to use Tor browser. It's a bundle that anonymizes your traffic. You can step it up right away and use it as your primary browser, but the slowdown of the internet traffic may discourage you. You can use Facebook's Tor link, and your internet service providers will no longer be able to tie your browsing to your real identity. You can use mail clients like Mozilla Thunderbird for Gmail. Webmail is extremely insecure. Every time you log in or refresh, someone can attempt to spoof the JavaScript and get access to your messages. This is the most common practice of the government hackers. Using mail client not only bypasses the security loophole, it also disables Google from planting those cookies through Gmail to track you down. For light browsing, use Brave, which works on any device and operating system. It blocks all advertisements and trackers by default. It only accepts the ethical ones which do not track you, so the right model is promoted. The choice is there for you to opt in or out of these advertisements as well. Learn to close your browser more frequently and configure it to delete your history and all the cookies. Google Chrome is the biggest pervert on your privacy. Everything gets sent to Google, and some add-ons were caught turning your microphone without letting you know. Use Chromium instead if you really love the look and feel. It's the same thing but in more blue and open source. Firefox is excellent for stepping things up. Configure it through privacy settings add-on to maximize your privacy protection. And install this set of add-ons: HTTPS everywhere, uBlock origin, privacy badger, self-destructing cookies, better privacy, disconnect, and random agent spoofer. Close your browser after each session and learn to use bookmarks instead of browsing history. You can right-click and choose bookmark all tabs if you want to remember your last session when you come back. This way, every time you close your browser, the new session will start as if it was a fresh install. No data to track, nothing to identify. The random agent spoofer will create a fake browser fingerprint, so the website won't be able to know what browser, device, and operating system you really use. You'll have to type in your passwords every single time, but it's not a problem for a password manager. The best option is to use master password, which works on all platforms. You shouldn't save your passwords on any browser because they are stored unencrypted. Anybody could get access to your device when you are on a public Wi-Fi, like at school, on a bus, or in a cafe, and steal your passwords. That's also a security upgrade on top of a better privacy. It's also super convenient to use password manager. Use encryption whenever you can. Encryption is your ammunition. It works.
Bitches.
For email, the easiest while still effective solution is offered by ProtonMail. You can set up your account completely anonymously through a hidden Tor link. You can send encrypted messages to non-ProtonMail users. It has beautiful user interface. You can set your messages to self-destruct at any time and nicely sort your inbox through tags. For instant messaging, go for Signal. You can do voice and video calls, send pictures and videos, and also send self-destructive messages. All is encrypted and the company is completely transparent, funded by donations. WhatsApp also implemented Signal's end-to-end encryption, but WhatsApp is Facebook now, and I don't trust Mark Zuckerberg. He's a crazy sociopath who'll one day take over Africa and become the new king of the third world. And that's it, the rest you can learn on the go. Now, what is this all good for? It's to kill their business model. We want technological advancement that everybody can enjoy, but we don't want billionaires making fortune while printing barcodes on our heads and building absolute surveillance state. This way, we limit the amount of data they can collect, and what gets collected cannot be turned back on us in form of targeted ads. It becomes useless. They will either not be able to make sense of the ambiguous data, or your configuration will block any attempt of incoming pervasive targeted advertisement.
Hello, Mr. Yakamoto. Welcome back to the Gap. How those assorted tank tops work out for you?
Remember, targeted marketing is not serving you. It's to maximize their profit, not your satisfaction. They won't choose the best product for you. They'll choose the one you'll pay the most for. There have been cases where some hotels were suggesting higher prices for those who search for rooms on iPhones or MacBooks. If we let profit hunting of the marketeers take over, in process, they'll completely ruin everything Western democracies have been building for centuries. There is a way we can beat this sickness, but we have to grow in numbers. Share this message if you agree, and let's do this fight. It's our turn. For more sources, I recommend you go to privacytools.io or follow their discussion on their subreddit. You can get more details on what to use for anything else, including search engines, social media, or other communicational alternatives. If you like this video, I would appreciate your feedback. Please share my work if you enjoyed, and feel free to subscribe.